You know, you hear very frequently people say things like everyone's creative. It's like, that's wrong, okay? It's wrong. It's just as wrong as saying that everyone's extroverted.
So, here we go. Jimmy, this some serious gourmet shit. Me and Vincent would have been satisfied with some freeze-dried Taster's Choice, right? And he sprays this serious gourmet shit on.
All right.
What flavor is this?
So we are live. Not really live. Anyways, I wanted to make this video to kind of start making videos again. And you know, a big thing that I've learned is I really don't want to be in front of the camera too much. I like to be behind the camera. But obviously there's, you know, things that you can benefit from being in front of the camera. So I'm gonna have to, you know, just get used to it. Pretty much you leave yourself up to be crucified, but how hypocritical would it be of me if I couldn't manage being in front of the camera and expect other people to be in front of the camera? So, you know, that's kind of one of the things that I'm working on. Also too, I wanted to let photography be the foundation of these videos and kind of share some of my brother's artwork. As you guys seen in the beginning of the video, he likes to draw, and currently he's incarcerated, so he's not able to, you know, really go out and experience life. So it's hard for him to create, and he has been, you know, slowing up on what he sends me. So I was hoping we can make these videos and kind of motivate him a little bit more. But also I was thinking about possibly not telling him. That way there's more like a dynamic within the videos, and everything that he sends or gives me or some of our conversations that we have, I'll possibly share with you guys. That way it would be more genuine versus me telling I'm making videos and everything just being, you know, superficial and fake, if that makes any sense. I did go out and grab a little hard drive. That way for now on, anything that I create and any photos and videos that I make, I'm gonna store on this one. As you guys know, it's not the camera gear that makes the photos or the videos. It's actually, you know, the person applying themselves to their work and what they're doing and working on storytelling and, you know, lighting and all this stuff. There's so much to it. You know, at first when I started, I was like, oh, I can do that. And then you start doing it and then you meet other people that are doing it and you realize that there's levels to it, there's layers. And, you know, with photography, every little bit of what you do with yourself, you know, the books you read, the people you meet, you know, the experiences you have, that really does play into your work. And all the great photographers that I've noticed, you're able to see them as a person through their work. So that's one of those things we're gonna work on. I'm gonna put this down now. Show you guys a camera that I got months ago. It is the Mamiya RZ67 Pro 2. It's a really cool camera. As you guys can see, it's pretty modular. Everything's manual, so it's like going from an automatic car to a manual stick shift. Now you have your focusing rings on both sides. You do have a fine focus, so if I was to shoot like a portrait or a person and I want to get the, you know, general focus and then I fine tune on the eye, I'm able to do that. Very, very heavy camera though. I like the sound of it. So when you, the lever, shutter, you have your advance here, film that goes right here in the back, which also detaches. If you're on like the fourth or fifth shot, you're able to take this off and use a different back with a different film roll in it if you need to. Then you can switch over to landscape or portrait. So you don't have to try and shoot, you know, awkwardly. You have your ISO adjustments here, your aperture. It's an overall pretty cool camera. And what's really cool though about the waist level finder, although it is inverted, it does have this little cool magnifier. If you're out in broad daylight, you're able to look through the magnifier without like introducing a lot of glare. But whenever you do introduce the prism finder on top, though it has a built-in light meter, which is awesome, it does weigh so much more. If I was to drop this thing, I don't know what would happen. And this has a lot of glass in it, but this is more so the setup. And then you would adjust like this. Pretty nice camera. I thought it'd be cool to show you guys because you don't really see a camera like this every day. Possibly not outside. I know people use this a lot for studio work in the past and a lot of magazine work. Some people have a misconception about film just because it's older that it doesn't produce good images. That's not true. I think it's more so like preference. Not a lot of people want to carry this around because of the weight. Also too, when you're shooting medium format, this only does like 10 shots on a roll. So it does get pretty costly. And then this is obviously the medium format roll, 120. And yeah, oh my God, I almost dropped it there.